side of the subway chill, you know what I'm saying? Original Compton's most wanted. First generation, you know what I'm saying? I gotta give it up to my homeboy, West Haven. Blast. You did DubCNN. Always fucking 100 with your boy, West up.
Yeah. Hey man, I'm Westy as a cowboy, a gun slanger, but I spoke Levi's while them guys spoke Wranglers. I'm not a stranger to the average gangbanger. Cock back, I aim a blue and a flamer. Chill cocky, a regular black Nazi. King T, you meet a new Ralph Mouth Posse. Copy, niggas was trying to pop me, but got popped on red lights, can't stop me. On them 14s, clean money green, gold shoe soles with the eagle on the toes. California 90221, real nigga on the run, your clowns don't want none. Raw like the smooth operator, hater. IG's move like Weasel up the elevator. Major, 5-star general, here and now. Luke the Van Draw, sport a chill, go home.
You know, right now I'm just smoking a blunt. As you can tell, it's fire. Chopping up some drugs, fucking with some drugs. Chilling with my big sis, Big Mama. We at her lab. We just getting it in, you know. Fresh out of jail. Been out for 3 months. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, all you fake ass rappers, you talking about jail and all that shit. I'm the first to say that ain't nothing to glorify. Half you niggas wouldn't make it through LA County. Wayside to light your ass up. Cause they lining shit up. You taking all fades. And if you don't take the fade, then you're gonna get packed. There's no way around it. So turn up if you want to, or be about that life. Me, I ain't about that life. I'm a G now. Big up to my own boy, Tiptoe, you know what I'm saying, from Broadway Gangsta, that was my seven. You know what I'm saying? 13 months, we did burpees, ate soups, watched movies, that's all we did.
That's right.
Now I'm back on the block with beats like gunshots. You know what I'm saying? Before I left, you know, I was producing a whole lot of shit. First of all, you know what I'm saying? Let me get back to who I am. For those that don't know, they call me Chill, the motherfucking Chill, the Chill, the Compton's Most Wanted. If y'all don't know what Compton's Most Wanted is, Google the shit, it's real. You know what I mean? It's really real. For those that know what's happening, West Up, you know what I mean? It's the Chill, MCA, Boom Bam, DJ Slip, Mighty Mike T, and my homeboy, Ant Capone. And what's happening to my little bro, the Folk? You know what I'm saying? That's Compton's Most Wanted. Now, MC8, you know what I'm saying? He got his shit cracking. Blue Stamp, boom, he doing his thing. The Chill got my shit cracking. Big Homie Music, you know what I'm saying? Boom, bam, he got companies, you know what I'm saying? He doing electrical and all that type of shit. Slip, building underwater robots. Mike T got the stupid ass mix of steel. And C, Ultimate Hustler, back briefcase type cat, you know what I'm saying? So, we got it all on lock from all corners, and we still firm Voltron and get it in heavy. So we got a Compton's Most Wanted album that we working on right now, coming. So we looking for that around Christmas time. Okay. I'm working on the time I did, 4 with 80. I was going to call it a mixtape, but now the motherfucker's so dope, I'm going to call it an album. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Chill, 4 with 80. That's coming out. Okay. I'm 80% done with this album that I got with my homeboy Big Tradey from the East Siders, my homeboy Corrupt from the Dog Pound, my homeboy Weasel Lope from the Pomona City Rocks.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And we call it the Dirty OGs. We like 80% done with that record. And big up to my homeboy Joseph Lawberg. You know what I'm saying? We're going to finish that up and have that ready for you. You know what I'm saying? Big up to the Moon Rock family. You know what I'm saying? Sun Rocks was happening.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And, shit, what else? I got a nephew, my nephew, Gunnamane 600, he real. Check his video on YouTube, every day. You know what I'm saying? That boy go real, real hard. That's my nephew. That's Boom Bam's son. So we gonna fuck with him on some shit. Okay. My homeboy Park Bowl, I'm working on this shit. That's my little homie from the neighborhood. And just staying active, man. Still doing beats. Yeah. Still got beats for everybody, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking that business, of course. You know what I mean? And just getting it in, staying active. We still got first generation coming.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? First generation coming. They was waiting on me to get home so we could all be together. Because first what happened was Gangsta went to jail. That's why he wasn't on those videos that we shot. Then right before Gangsta got out, King T went to jail. You know what I'm saying? Then he got out. Right before he got out, J.O. went to jail. You know what I mean? And then before J.O. come home, I went to jail. You know what I'm saying? So we want to just make sure that we all present in the same room and everybody's available for, you know, touring purposes, because it's a real big group. You know what I mean? When we turn up stages, man, we knock shit down. That's just too much history in one room.
Right.
It's very powerful.
Definitely.
You know, with shit like that, you got to take time and do it. You know what I mean? You don't want to just jump at it because you don't want to get leader people misconstrued or just have them on some like, damn, that's a fake group. We really, really a group, first generation.
Well, who?
It's Corrupt.
Yeah.
It's me, Chill, MC8, Gangsta from the Conrads, King T, J.O. Felony, Battle Cat, and my main man, Sir Jinx. You know what I'm saying? And we the first generation, you know what I'm saying? And you know, check the videos, Killing Me Softly and Sharks in the Water, you know what I'm saying? That shit is all gas for the people that ain't heard it. You know what I'm saying? But we still coming up. We still coming, we still doing shows. I still got songs and shit that I'm mixing and putting together. Jinx putting together some shit.
Jinx?
Yeah, we doing verses over and shit like that, freaking shit updating.
Right.
So that shit still coming at the right time.
That's right.
You dig? I started out rapping, you know what I mean? Like in school, me, eight, my cousin Cat, not Battle Cat, my cousin Cat, you know what I'm saying? From May 6th out of Sacramento. I got a cold, my bad, but we used to rap and have rap routines and shit, you know what I'm saying? We went to Hamilton Junior High, you know, then we went to Jordan. We was like any other kids, we was B-boys, you know what I'm saying, rapping and shit. And I was the beatboxer, you know what I'm saying? I had mad beats and Aiden Cat just bust routines. You know what I mean? I used to come in rapping too. And DJ Al Capone, he was the first one to have some turntables. He went to school with us too. And Warren G went to school with us. Snoop, he went to school down the street from us, but he used to come up there all the time with Warren G. Mm. And we used to battle and, you know, have fun like kids, you know what I'm saying? But I was the beatbox. You know, when we got out of school, you know, like 12th grade, we dropped out. Shit. Me and A was like, fuck school, because we hooked up with Unknown, Lonzo. It was doing the Compton compilation. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. We was busting on that shit. Rob's Too Funky, that was our first cut. You know what I mean? I had a little bucky. You know what I mean? My baby mama, I was 16 years old. You know what I mean? With my little kid in the car, we smash up to Lonzo's. First time ever being in the studio. Met Slip up there, big old nigga on the SP-1200, banging on the drums. I was intrigued by that shit, how he was making them sounds come off that motherfucker.
Right.
And me and 8 had that rapid fire. Every beat he played and shit, we was spitting to that motherfucker. All gas, no brakes. And he gave us a CD, oh shit, damn, a cassette. A cassette of the beat, Rhymes Too Funky. We went back to 8 Mama House, you know what I'm saying, in Compton on Johnson, and 8 just started pinning that shit. You know what I'm saying? I was the beatbox, so I wasn't good with writing raps back then.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So 8 was pinning all that shit. I was the chill MC, and he was MC 8, Compton's Most Wanted. Then the same night we recorded Duck Sick, the same night we recorded Duck Sick, I was with my homeboy Crazy D, my SA partner from NWA. But the same night we did that song, I left, I jumped in a G-Ride, stole a car, you know what I'm saying? It was riding, was fucking with this little bitch, you know what I'm saying? Trying to go over her house, And me, Crazy D, and 8 back at 8 Mama House, we was gonna smoke and drink and kick it. You know, we just did a jam. So I decided to dip off to the Broad House first. The police get up on me. You know what I'm saying? They jack, take me to jail. You know what I'm saying? This is the same night that we did the duck shit. And Unknown got me out. He went and talked to the judge. You know what I'm saying? And the judge like basically showed leniency towards me, let me out and shit. That's why I ain't on a couple of cuts on the Issa Compton thing out. The day before we did Growing Up in the Hood, I went to jail, shooting in the residential area. Behind a bitch. And man, police wouldn't show me no love and shit. I went over there tripping, went back to A Mama House and had the whole block of Johnson filled up with police. For the chill. I told you this shit choke. And I'm steady smoking this shit. Damn. Yeah, but the whole block of motherfucking Johnson Street in Compton was filled up with police. You know what I'm saying? Behind that shit. Took me to jail. I'm like, damn, man, I got a video to do tomorrow. Damn, number one song out there for the Boys in the Hood soundtrack. You know what I'm saying? Growing Up in the Hood, Compton's Most Wanted. You know what I mean? We put in so much work, so much, you know, work on that song. I was excited about it. Cube was, you know, we had Cube with us and all that. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, you know what I mean? Motherfucking police take me to jail the next day, man. You know what I'm saying? And said that motherfucker Unknown couldn't get me out that time.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So when I touched down, you know, my deuce wasn't mad at me, 8 wasn't mad at me, but you know, he you know, he kept it 100 with me, like, nigga, I'ma keep this shit rocking, nigga, into whether you going to jail or not, but you gonna have to stay out of trouble.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm like, that's what's up, man. Like, let's just do this record and shit. So, you know, I was going on tour with him and shit like that.
Yeah.
I got some more trouble, man, with the jail again, man. When I got out this time, you know what I'm saying, it was Music to Drive By album. You know, the company, they needed 2 members of Compton's Most Wanted.
Right.
By that time, they was working on the Music to Drive By album. Mike T, you know what I'm saying, you know, that's why he's on the cover.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You know, that's our DJ, he's CMW. That's my own boy, Mike T from Inglewood. You know what I'm saying? He's from CMW, no doubt.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And, you know, but me and 8 was the group signed or whatnot. But, you know, 8 and Unknown and Slip, they did what was right. You know what I'm saying? Kept the deal. You know what I mean? I was the one fucking up. You know what I mean? So, you know, I was still touring with the group when I got out. I still was active with 8, but it wasn't the same because I wasn't doing no rapping. I ain't doing no joints on the album.
Mm.
You know, on the Growing Up in the Hood song for the Boys in the Hood soundtrack, that's me rapping on the soundtrack, on the song.
Right.
But that's 8 on the video. You know what I'm saying? Doing both verses. 8 wrote the song, you know what I'm saying? So, you know. But I wasn't there for the video because I went to jail the day before that motherfucker.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Fresh khaki and penalties in the trunk. Fresh K-Swiss, all that shit. And the motherfucker was like, fuck you and them khakis. Took my ass to jail.
Man.
You know what I'm saying? But after the Music to Drive By album, I was out. Hey, that started working on Become Strapped. And that's when it turned to MCA featuring Compton's Most Wanted. You know what I mean? Because, you know, like I say, he did what was right. He kept the deal. And as well as, you know what I'm saying, there was a bunch of poo butt shit going on too with Unknown. You know what I'm saying? So, we sabotaged from them. I really didn't have a pot to piss in to say anything, but I know he fucked us in our earlier days. You know what I'm saying? For his publishing and royalties, and, you know, even on our advances and shit, that nigga was hitting us with crumbs and shit. So, you know, 8 slipped, they got wind of that shit, you know, and he got dumped. You know what I mean? And he got dumped.
Mm.
And, you know, niggas kept rocking, you know what I'm saying? We had an attorney named John Smith. He was rocking for us, hooking up a lot of shit. So A did the We Come Strapped out. That's me and Bull Bam in the background on the pool tables and shit. We opened up the cover. And, you know, we went on tour rocking and shit. Ada got a situation with Craig Coleman over at Atlantic, when Junior Mafia was finna come out.
Oh, okay.
And they was trying to give us a deal with for NOTR. Me, Boom Bam, this is how we was introducing Boom Bam to the world. You know what I'm saying? And then this is how I was getting reintroduced to the world.
Right.
Niggas on the Run.
Right.
And it was me, Boom Bam, and MCA, a group. And we had a situation with Craig Coleman, and, you know, A got the loop, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, shit seemed, went kind of sour because, you know, people thought they wanted this much money, and, you know, A was giving people what he thought was right, and, you know, Slip wasn't feeling it, and, you know, whatever it was. Me and Bam caught in the middle because it's our record. I'm just trying to get back on, and, you know, Slip kept the record, and we got dropped.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We got dropped. Both of them niggas is my homeboys. I love them niggas to death, but the business of the shit got me and Bam fucked up. So, of course, you know, I started doing what I was doing at first, ended up got in trouble again, went to jail, got out, you know what I mean? Then, you know, my homeboy Bird was around, rest in peace. You know, him and Lil Hawk. You know, we was fucking with them, and we was just a solid ass crew, just touring, representing eight. You know what I mean? And through it all, I have little sprats to where I was going to jail, and, you know, we be on and we be off, you know what I'm saying? Then me and Ada had that little splat last time I got out of jail, and, you know, we reconciled that shit because that's my bro. We was just mad at each other. You know, niggas go through that type of shit, but that's my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Well, everything. You know what I'm saying? I'll die for, I mean, well, I ain't gonna say that, but, you know, I'll ride for my nigga.
That's right.
Everything.
That's right.
Y'all feel me?
Yeah, yeah. What's your top five MCs of all time?
West Coast or East Coast? Or down south?
You know, just whoever you feel, you know what I'm saying?
I got more than five, though.
Okay.
Because I gotta go by genre. Okay. It's all different music under the same umbrella.
Right.
So if it was East Coast, I gotta say my own boys, Redman and Meth.
Yeah.
I like AZ. I like Nas. You know what I'm saying? I like Busta.
Yeah.
EPMD, that's my favorite. You know what I mean? Big Daddy Kane, KRS-One, Rakim.
Mm-hmm.
On the West Coast, I like Cube. I like Ren. I like Corrupt.
Mm-hmm.
I like Daz. Yeah. I like Sugar Free. You know what I'm saying? I like Quick.
Right.
I like Caution.
Okay.
I like Dub C, you know what I'm saying? I like YG. I like Glasses Malone, Big to the Boy, Nipsey, Game, yeah. You know what I'm saying? T-Fly. You know, I got too many to say five.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If it's down south, I like Face. I like Bun B.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I like A-Ball and MJG. You know what I'm saying?
So you can say you can't put them in just a, it's a...
It's just too many.
Right, you know right.
It's just too... Because I'm a producer. So it ain't just me liking the MC. I like the joints that they did.
Right.
That inspired me to do different type of shit.
Yeah,
you
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And all of those is different genders of artists under one umbrella. You know what I mean? So that's the authenticity of hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? Those groups that I name. All those dudes, you know what I'm saying, make major contributions to not just West Coast, East Coast, down south hip hop, but just hip hop, period. Well, you know what I mean?
Well, let's say it like this then. Out of all of those that you name, you know, which ones would you want to work with as a, whether it's a producer, you know, as a producer or as a artist? You know what I mean?
Shit. All them names I named from the West Coast, uh-huh. I done worked with them.
Right, right. I figured.
Them all my bros.
Yeah.
Half them niggas on the East Coast, I done worked with them too.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? My nigga Red, man, that's my dog.
Yeah.
If it was down south, I would like to get out with the homeboy Face. He got out with Eight on the Music the Drive-By album. I still slapped that on N2D. Compton, MCA, Compton's Most Wanted, Scarface, that's the joint.
Yeah.
And I like what he doing now. When I came home, when I first got home, I'm, you know, flipping through the YouTube, looking at what's cracking and all that. And I ran into Face video Problem. And that shit is gas on me. You know what I'm saying? My nigga looking good, and he busting like a motherfucker. So I would definitely want to get out with my old boy Face. I don't know where AZ at, but in the pen, I used to be doing my little burpees and all that shit. But I used to always bump him and Nas. Life's a bitch and then you die. That nigga hard as a motherfucker. That nigga was spitting on that motherfucker. Then on the Firm album and shit, that nigga was gassed too. So I would like to get into it. Get into a frenzy with him as well.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Big up to my homeboy Nas. I mean, you know, it's whoever got heat, dog. You know what I'm saying? Whoever got, I don't give a fuck if a nigga 15 years old and shit. If he got gas on me, I'ma produce the tightest shit I can produce for him.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Cause my name is involved with it, with my brand.
So
you know what I mean?
So what you think about the you know, the younger guys that's in the game right now that you know when you talk about some of the people like Young Thug and, you know, guys like that, because we already know, you know, Kendrick is doing his thing, you know what I mean, you know, guys like that. But then you got those other dudes like I said, like Young Thug, you know, and guys like that. What do you think about those?
I mean, I really ain't really, if I heard, man, I don't even be knowing half the shit be playing.
I feel you.
You know what I mean? I'm an old school cat. Some of that shit be banging like a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I heard a lot of different shit about the kid, Young Thug. I don't know if I was listening to his song or not. I probably was lower in the club. Shit probably was knocking. But for this him personally, I don't know him to speak on him or whatever.
Right.
Some of the shit that, you know, he done put out there, I'm like, I wouldn't have did that. But I don't know the cat. You know what I'm saying?
Right, so, right.
You know, but, you know, needless to say, you know, for this, you know, the new wave of hip-hop and how everything is cracking these days, you know what I'm saying? Shit, I love it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because it's competitive.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And, you know, I don't like that everything sound the same. I definitely don't like that.
Right.
You know what I mean? But, you know, it's not just different genders of hip-hop, like I said, under one umbrella. Now it's different genders of hip-hop under 10 umbrellas. You got different, real different genders of hip-hop. You got the ID Love rap. You got the swag rap. You got the gangster rap. You got the trap rap. You got the pop rap, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got the, you know, all these different kind of, you know what I'm saying, hip-hops and shit, you know what I mean? You got R&B rap, you know what I mean? And,
right.
You know, drum and bass, and, you know, all that type of shit, you know what I mean? So, it's like, you know, I like what motherfuckers doing, as long as it's clever to me, you know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck if he 15, 19, 20, shit, to my age, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shit, this nigga's my age still cracking, you know what I'm saying? Look at Jay-Z, that nigga on his tip.
Yeah.
Can't even hate on him. He got a badass wife. You know what I'm saying? He got right. kids. You know what I'm saying? Nigga own all these businesses and shit. You know what I mean? Shit, he trucked the game. Who wouldn't want to do that?
Right.
You know what I mean? But, you know, it ain't meant for everybody. You know? And me, I just do it for the love of music. I love what I do. You know what I mean? You ain't going to do nothing that you don't love doing. So me, I ain't going to drive no forklift. And I ain't going to flip no burgers or none of that shit. I'm gonna rock these beats, and everything I do is gonna be music orientated. You know what I'm saying? Whether it's with the youth, whether it's with the G's, whether it's with the out of country folks or out of state folks or whatever, you know what I'm saying? I'm just gonna stay powered up till I die.
That's right.
For real. You know what I'm saying?